Hey everybody, Greg and Dr. J here with another Q&A on the topic of coffee. Coffee is drunk around the world. However, there are more tea drinkers in the world than there are coffee drinkers. Did you know that, Dr. J?
I did not.
I was shocked.
Wow.
Yeah. But
Interesting.
coffee has a genetic component to it too, right? A connection anyway to our genes, whether we're okay to drink coffee or it doesn't agree with us. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I have to say I'm a coffee addict and
Oh dear.
but I wasn't always. I had my first cup of coffee when I was 47.
What?
And yeah, and I was in Costa Rica. And the only thing in the mini bar when we got to the hotel was a coffee liqueur. I just hated the taste of it. And
You
anyway,
like the cafe liqueur?
well, yeah, I tasted it and I was like, oh, this isn't bad. It's really sweet. And they
Yeah.
covered the coffee up. I'm like, okay. And downed one of those. And my boyfriend at the time woke up in the morning. He says, good morning, hon. How'd you sleep? And I was like, didn't, but I wrote a book. I wrote my second book the first time I had coffee, and I was like, wow, I see why people like this stuff. This is amazing. Like, I mean, my brain was going. Anyway, I've become a fan. I'm a big fan of coffee. And however, there are issues around coffee, and it is one of the most heavily sprayed with pesticide products in the world. So it really does pay to get an organic, a good source of organic, and fair trade would be a good idea too, and make sure that we support people in other countries who are making a living. I'm pretty passionate about doing that. But there are genetic variants that can keep you from breaking coffee down. And so the one of them is the NAT gene, another one is the ADORA gene. And if you have those genetic variants, you're going to be very slow at clearing caffeine out of the body. And so even a little bit in the morning can interfere with your sleep and create
Bummer.
problems for some people and cause jitteriness and feeling of low blood sugar. For other people, they can drink coffee all day long and it clears out of there easily and they can go to sleep fine. So there's a great variation between certain genetic variants and others. But if I would encourage you, if you're having trouble sleeping, try getting off coffee or at least going to decaf for a while and see if that doesn't clear it up. Because a lot of my patients, they it was hard for them to give up their coffee. They're like, no, I'm not going to do it. I'm like, but really, sleep is a big deal.
Sleep is very important. And even though I was told not to drink coffee and to switch to decaf, I switched to half and half, half decaf, half regular. And then I just gave the decaf away and decided that I would just have it in the morning. And that was the key. Because I didn't drink it all through the day, but maybe 3 or 4 in the afternoon, I would have another one or a tea. And I still have tea some days, not all the time. I was erring on the side of caution. I wasn't sleeping well, but I think there were other things that were also, the histamine thing was off the charts at the time. And yeah, I think again, it comes down to what's going to work for the person. For me, it was moderation. It wasn't giving it up. I missed that little zing from the caffeine.
Yeah. I just tried an interesting, I don't want to do a commercial for a company. I'm not affiliated with them, but they make a product called PX, which is what caffeine breaks down into. And that's what gives you the energy without the jitteriness. And so it's really good. And I can actually have several cups during the day and not feel that jitteriness
Oh,
because
it's a
I'm,
drink.
yeah, it's coffee. It's, but it's
Oh.
broken down into the PX. So you can get an espresso or you can get a medium roast or a light roast or what.
Wow.
Not cheap, but I really am so far really liking it. If I get 2 cups, I'm pretty jittery. I'm like,
Really? See, I don't get jittery. If I had an espresso,
yeah, that's what I have.
I would be jittery. But I used to
Yeah.
drink espresso after dinner. Not at home, but we'd go out to dinner. It's 9 or 10 o'clock by the time we get done. We'd all sit around and have an espresso, go right to sleep at home. But now
Wonderful.
I couldn't do that now. My body has changed.
And there are certain nutrients that'll help you clear caffeine better as well. And one of them is protein. Like you can put a protein powder in your coffee and that helps. It helps the NAT enzyme that requires cysteine to help break down coffee. So it's a trick that you can try as well. If you're just like me, I'm not going to give up my coffee. I will take whatever to balance it because I'm an addict now. I do believe it is good for you. It's full of antioxidants and can fire up your brain and make you more more clear and focused. Too much is not good. And again, some people just not going to do well on any. Other people can do a lot. So when you get your genes tested, it'll show you, are you good at clearing caffeine or not? And the slider that we show you will go back and forth, and you can see where you're at as far as clearance of coffee or
Now, tea
caffeine.
would fall into the same category.
Yeah, and it's got a different type of caffeine. And so again, for certain people, they might be more sensitive to tea than coffee, or to chocolate also has caffeine. And so they're slightly different, and they can have different effects on the body. So just playing around with it, trying decaf. It's not fun to get off coffee because it can give you a
Gives you
rebound.
a headache.
Ah, man, it's tough. But if you maybe try some protein powder in it and see if you can tolerate it better and it doesn't interfere with your sleep, or try cutting it in half like you did, do half and half decaf. There's some great mushroom coffees out there too
Yeah, I
that,
have those for the afternoon sometimes.
yeah, I do too. And they're really awesome.
And most of them I find have MCT oil in them, which is another great food. MCT oil has to be a food if it's an oil.
Yeah, it can really keep the caffeine from doing the spike and then down. It sustains the release of the caffeine when you put MCT oil in there. So it can even out the buzz a little bit.
And that was what the original Bulletproof coffee, can't remember his name,
Yeah.
but was to
Yeah.
put butter or
Right.
MCT oil, which I never did. Did you ever do that?
Yeah, butter is great. I actually love
I
butter. At
bet it
first, I was
is.
like, what? Butter?
The more delivery systems for butter that I get, the better.
I know,
So
me
I
too.
should try it.
Anything that delivers butter is
Exactly right. My
butter.
friend recently said, I made Irish soda bread and I had forgotten how dry it is and why we always had plenty of butter around. I can't slather it on like I used to. I was like, why? I'm sorry. I
Yeah.
mean, you have to. It's one of those occasions, St. Patrick's Day.
Right.
Yeah.
Do it.
Do it, do it. All right. Coffee, tea, caffeine. Add it to the pile of things that could be good, could be not so good. We just have to find out what is right for us. And that, I think, is all we have to say about this.
Yeah, it's a love-hate relationship we have with coffee.
I think a lot of people would agree with that. Even people that know they shouldn't have that third cup, they're like stressed, they're at their desk, they're bored, whatever, we reach for it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like the morning thing. I get up and I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna get my cup of coffee. I'm excited.
I used to be like that. I've taught myself to like black coffee. I never in a million years thought I would.
Wow,
But I
me
have a
too.
cup of black coffee at 9, and then I don't have anything else till around 10 when I have breakfast. I never was the person who woke up and had a cup of coffee, but within the first 45 minutes to an hour, I was drinking coffee. But I just decided to see what my body would feel if I gave it a break. And it feels
And
pretty good.
I've heard people say they lose weight, you know,
Yeah.
because when they stop drinking coffee, and maybe it's the creamer, but and a lot of people at Starbucks,
Oh, God, those things are.
frappuccinos that are 1,000 calories per,
Yeah.
they think, oh, it's just coffee. It's not gonna, yeah, adds up. But it also, I think, stimulates the appetite.
Oh, I think so. Yeah,
Yeah.
definitely. So does exercise. Can we get rid of exercise?
Let's do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. On that note, peeps, we'll be back with another Q&A. We hope to hear from you soon about whatever is on your mind that you would like us to talk about. Thank you so much, Dr. J.
Thank you, GC.